Hi children, welcome back again. Okay, in this today's video we are going to discuss about a new topic. The topic name is the world around us. How is the world around us? It's a very beautiful, it's very colorful. We are enjoying the world, whatever it is there around us. So as soon as I see the world, as I see the outside, look outside of my house, I can see many more things. Like I can see many number of plants in my own garden. I can see compound, gate, road is there, ground is there. I can see many type of animals, that cow, ox, donkeys, dog, cat, or the rat is there, is insect, the cockroach is there, and some many other insects are there, butterflies are there. If I go somewhere some far distance, distance I can walk. If I walk there, I can see a road is there. Some many vehicles are moving on the road. And if I see just upside, I can see the sky, I can see the stars, I can see the sun, moon. And if I see like this bit in this area, there is a big mountain. There are varieties of rocks are there. Then I can see, if I see like this, I can see the big tree is there. Mango tree, neem tree, banyan tree. And on that tree, there are some birds which are very colorful, which I know. Their names I know. And which some birds are there. Really, I don't know their names, but they are very colorful, very cute, very pretty. Okay, so like this, we can see variety of things in our world. Then can you just differentiate which type of varieties are there? Yes, very good. There are two types of varieties. One is living and another one is non-living. And in the non-living thing, again we have two types, that is, one is man-made non-living thing and another one is natural non-living things. So like this, I can see a pond, I can see a river, I can see a lake, I can see a ocean, I can see the big tank, water tank, syntax, isn't it? So like this, artificial also we can see and the natural also we can see. Living and non-living things we can see, especially living and non-living things. So in the non-living things, natural non-living things, which are natural non-living things? Natural non-living things. So what are non-living things? We will see. Non-living things are those which doesn't have the life for themselves. They don't have the life. Then natural non-living things, I can see the water, river is flowing, I can see the ocean, I can see the mountain, I can see the rock, I can see the some other non-living things like a pond, lake, isn't it? So we can see like this, naturally they are present around us and they are just non-living things. Then in this, again I can see another one type, that is artificial or man-made man-made non-living things. That is, artificial or man-made non-living things are those which are made by the man. For example, I am here in my house. House is made by man, isn't it? Constructed by man. Then these walls are non-living. This board is made up of artificial. It is made by man. Then this is non-living things. Chalk piece is non-living things. Duster is non-living things. I have a door here, non-living thing. Window here, non-living thing. And I have vehicles. Those are also non-living things. I have a gate, I have a compound, non-living things, isn't it? We have boxes, we have some other like material, plastic materials or metals, metal materials, and fiber materials and the materials which are made by the bricks, which are made by the plastic and brass, copper, like this, that those may be the metals and non-metals. These all things are artificial. Of course, we got these all from the nature itself, but these all are completely artificial and man-made. So like this, these two types of things we can see. One is non-living thing which are naturally present in our world. And another one is artificial and man-made non-living things. And other than this, we can see the living things. What are these living things which have the life? Human being, animals, plants, insects, small or big. Okay, animals mean small or big. Or insects mean small or big. Okay, and the plants mean small or big. Plants means the whole plant kingdom. That may be a small herb, shrub, or trees, whatever it may be. But we can see these all are living things in our nature or in our world. And it is completely given by the God. Okay, God has created us and God has given us. These all are living things. Then do you know the differentiation between the living things and the non-living things? Of course we know living things have the life. Non-living things does not have the life. There is life for the living thing. And non-living thing, there is no life for the non-living things. And living things grow. Growth is there for living things. And non-living things, there is no growth. Then, living things reproduce. Reproduce just like they themselves. Another one young, they are going to reproduce. But non-living things will not reproduce. And living things breathe. Actually, this should be breathing or breath. Non-living things will not breathe. Actually, this should be the first or second one. But we are keeping this one in a fourth. Breathing, all the living things breathe, but non-living things will not breathe. All the living things response for change. Response, we have learned this all. Response for change in the nature or change in the surrounding or change in the climate. But for non-living things, it doesn't matter whatever the climate changes or suddenly the area, this atmosphere changes, the air changes. For non-living things, it is no matter for them. But for the living things, they are going to respond for the changes. And these have life and death. Life and death. But non-living things, either life nor death. Living things have the life cycle. Life cycle. But the non-living things, there is no life cycle for the non-living things. This is how we can differentiate between the living things and the non-living things. Why we are telling them as a living thing? I will take one sparrow and one big rock. Okay, sparrow will come and sit on the rack or a rock. And after some time it will fly. And again it will come and sit with some grains and some fruit. It will eat. The rock will be there only in the same place. Sparrow has come for two times on the rock, and it once it was eating and once it was just taking the rest on the rock. There is no change in the rock because it's a non-living thing. And one the years after, the many years have spent, sparrow was very small before and it has grown up to this, but the rock is same because it has no growth. It is not at all breathing. And it is not at all eating because it's a non-living thing. But and the sparrow is the living thing. I hope you have got the clear picture about these things, whatever we have discussed in this today's video. That is living thing, non-living thing. In the living thing, we have only one. The animals, human beings, plants, insects, birds, all will come. Non-living things, we have two types. One is natural non-living things and another one is man-made or artificial non-living things. And why we call living things and non-living things? Because of these all characters of the living things. Where these characters will not follow or these are not these non-living things will not show any of these characters. So we will not call them as a living things. So before ending this video, I will give you some questions. Write down what are living things, give example. What are non-living things, give example. And what are man-made non-living things, give examples. I hope you will do this homework. And in the next video, we are going to discuss about how the things are from the nature or from the environment or from the world are helpful for us. Okay, until then, enjoy this video and learn whatever we have discussed in this video, and write down the homework whatever is given in this video. Let us meet in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.